Okay, so let's do more limits. Limits, limits, limits. So I said in this video I was going to do 11 and 12. So these both deal with logarithms. So 11 is the limit as x approaches 3 from the right of the natural logarithm of x squared minus 9. One thing you would definitely want to remember is the graph of the natural logarithm. So there's x, there's y. The natural logarithm goes through 1, 0. Why is that? Well, I'll leave that for you to think about. So here's y equals ln of x. As you get closer and closer to 0 from the right, the natural logarithm will just spike down to negative infinity. Okay, so if I tried to substitute in 3, if I tried to substitute in x equals 3, I would get the natural logarithm of 9 minus 9, which is the natural logarithm of 0, which is undefined. You can't plug 0 into the natural logarithm. If you don't believe me, put it in your calculator, see what happens. So, and again, why is the natural logarithm of 0 undefined? If you don't know the answer to that, and you're doing this stuff in calculus, I would say you're missing out on some important stuff, so you might want to consider that. Okay, so the idea is, in this case, as x approaches 3 from the right, x squared minus 9, that's going to get closer and closer to, well, so I'm getting closer and closer to 3. I'm using 3.1, 3.01, 3.001. The numbers I'm going to get out are going to get closer and closer to 0, but they're going to approach 0 from the right. So again, I'm going to get positive numbers out. If I take something a little bit bigger than 3, square it, subtract 9, I'm going to get a number that's close to 0, but it's positive. So we can just write this. We can say, well, the limit as x approaches 3 from the right of ln of x squared minus 9. The way I would write this is I would write this as the ln of 0 from the right. So again, this notation's fine. What it says is, it says x is getting closer and closer and closer to 0, but again, it's positive. And I want to know what happens to the y values on this graph, on the natural logarithm graph. What we just said is x gets closer and closer and closer to 0 from the right. Well, the y values on the graph go down to negative infinity, and that is going to be your solution. So if you don't remember the graph of natural logarithm, I would be stuck. Notice I'm not graphing the natural logarithm of x squared minus 9. I'm just graphing the natural logarithm of x. Okay, so be careful about that. That's probably a distinction worth pointing out. 12, sorry if I sound a little miserable here. Your humble narrator is a tad under the weather. So, number 12, the limit as x approaches infinity. We've got the ln of x squared minus the natural logarithm of 2x plus 1. So again, logarithm stuff, just to remind you, properties of logarithms. If you have the natural logarithm of a product, that becomes addition. So the natural logarithm of A times B is the natural logarithm of A plus the natural logarithm of B. This works for any logarithm, not just natural logarithms. Products become pluses. Hey, if I had division, I bet that becomes subtraction, which it does. Probably the last one that's definitely another one you want to know. If you have a constant out front, so a constant multiplied by the natural logarithm of x, it says that constant can just go upstairs as an exponent. So the only property we really need in this one is the second one. But just to remind you, there's the other three, because you could easily, you know, tweak this problem and have to use the first one or the third. All right, so using my formulas here, that is playing the role of my a, so there's my ln of a, there's my minus ln of b. So again, if you read it, you know, right to left, it says this is going to be the same thing as the limit as x goes to infinity. Again, it gets grouped into a single logarithm. That's going to be x squared over 2x plus 1. So I'm going to jump down here to give myself some more space. Now, okay, so This is a lot like, you know, the problems we did in number 8. Where are they at? Like in number 8, number 9. 8 we actually factored and canceled, so no problem there. I take it back. Like really more so, I should say, excuse me, not like 8 at all. More like number 9. Okay, those were the ones where we had limits going to infinity or dividing by highest powers. So this problem is very much like number 9. So there's a rule that says you can pull the limit inside. So really this is the natural logarithm of the limit as x goes to infinity. I'm going to give myself some space, x squared divided by 2x plus 1. I'm going to do the same thing that we did a second ago. We looked at the highest power of x in the denominator, and we divided everything by that. So the highest power of x in the denominator is x to the first. So I'm going to have x squared over x, 2x over x, 1 over x. I'm going to clean that up. So we've got the natural logarithm of the limit as x goes to infinity. Well, x squared over x, that's just going to leave me with an x in the numerator. 2x over x, that's 2 plus 1 over x. Well, now in this case, what are we left with? We've got the natural logarithm of, as x goes to infinity, well, x is going to infinity. We've got 2. We would have 1 over infinity. So that's the natural logarithm of infinity over, well, I've got 2 plus, we've already seen, you know, 1 over a large number, that's 0. 2 plus 0 is going to be 2. So a big number divided by 2 is still going to be a big number. So the idea is, as x gets bigger, 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 what happens to the y values on natural logarithm? Well, as x gets bigger, 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 the y values keep going off to infinity. So natural logarithm grows really slowly, but it will get to infinity. So it's a shame your student loan debt does not grow logarithmically, but by the same token, that would mean your retirement fund grows logarithmically, and you don't want that. So, okay, so two problems there involving logarithms. Again, in the next video, I will start looking at the trig problems, and then in the last video, we'll finish off the problems that involve the limit involving e.